Owned Pro is a plugin for OBS Studio that gives you access to graphic packs which you can use on your stream, and you can also subscribe to it to get access to more than 200 completely animated stream packs with overlays, alerts, labels and more. And since Owned also updated their plugin, I decided to make an overview of everything you can do with Owned Pro. They didn't pay me for this video, but they are working on my rebranding, which I will show you right now. So this is a little gesture toward them because they asked me if I wanted to make an update video. And before I go over everything here, a quick heads up. So their overlays obviously work for all streaming platforms, it's just graphics, but their alerts only work for Twitch at the moment. They are working on YouTube and Facebook and it will be launched in late 2021. So just a quick update for that, but you can use all their overlays, of course, that's not specific to one platform. Okay, so if you still have to buy Owned Pro, you can go to my subscriptions in the general tab, and then right here you will be able to click on a button. You can pay for 1 month, 3 months or 12 months. The longer you subscribe for, the cheaper it will get. I already subscribed, so let's go to my overview and then let's see what you can do with Owned Pro. So right here you see an overview of your active overlay and then your active alerts. So when you go to the alerts on the left, they will see that you can choose between a bunch of alerts here. There are 16 pages, they have a lot of designs and they have equally as much overlays as you see right here. So for every overlay pack, for example the dark mode series here, there is also an alert pack as you see right here, dark mode. And the fact that they have such a big library of designs you get access to when you subscribe is the reason that I think that if you're looking for a subscription based graphic service where you pay a monthly fee and you get a bunch of designs which you can use on your stream and switch between them as much as you want, is that Owned Pro is a pretty good option. The dark mode series here is my favorite pack, so let's click on it. And then when you click on install alerts pack, you will see that you get a message your selected alerts pack was successfully installed. So right now when you go to my overview and then when we refresh the page, you will see that the dark mode series is my active alert right now. Now you see no active overlay and we can't install an overlay right here on the website. We need to install the OBS Studio plugin and then install an overlay directly in OBS Studio. So that's what we're gonna do right now. Here you can see plugin, download plugin. You just click on that and then it will start downloading. Then when the plugin is installed, we will open it in OBS and then we will need a license key, and that's this one right here. You click on show license key and then you just click on this copy icon to copy it, click on got it, and then right now we are ready to install the plugin, and then we can just paste this license key. You will have this key whether you're using the free version of Owned Pro or the paid version. It's just a way to link your online account with the plugin in OBS Studio. Okay, so I'm gonna install the program right now, and here you gotta be careful because a lot of people make a mistake right here. I got a lot of comments on my previous video about Owned Pro that people couldn't find it in OBS Studio, and that's because of the part right here. So you see, it's going to install it in my program files x86. Now when I right click OBS Studio on my taskbar, I right click it again, go to properties, then you see that OBS is actually installed in my normal program files folder. So take a look at the location where OBS is installed, so in this case in program files OBS Studio, and then you want to make sure that this one here is the same. So instead of the 86 folder, I want to click on browse right now, and you see OBS is actually in this folder. When I unfold it, you will see that when I scroll a bit right here, OBS Studio. And now the second mistake, you don't want to select OBS Studio and then click on OK, because then it's going to install it in program files OBS Studio, OBS Studio. So what they want you to do is to look in which program files folder OBS is installed, in this case the normal one, then click on browse and just select the general program files folder and click on OK. They are automatically adding /OBS Studio behind it. So that's the process. Now you click on next, you click on yes, you click on next, click on install, click on finish, and now when we launch OBS, we should find Owned Pro in the tools, and there we go, right now it works. We click Owned Pro and then they will ask our license key. I already told you to copy it. If you didn't do it or you skipped that part, go to your dashboard. Right here you see license key, you click show key and then you click the copy button. Okay, right now we go back to OBS Studio and then we paste it right here, and then you click redeem license key. And by the way, this is both for the free and the premium version. You will need a key to link your account to the plugin in OBS. And then once installed, let's close it again. when you go to Tools Unknown Pro right now. And as you see, there are always a few free designs on top, and then all the other ones are premium. There are a lot of designs right here. So now when you want to install a design, for example, Dartmouth series, I said that I like this, you click on it, you can preview everything. And then a new feature that they just added is that you can choose the language of your overlay. You can install it in another language. So yeah, that's pretty neat. We're gonna select English right now, click on install design, and then it will just start installing the design. And there we go. We have all the scenes right here. Now I'm gonna show you the basics of the setup right now. If you want a complete step-by-step guide of everything that's inside of a pack and how to change it, like the specific labels, your socials, stuff like that, then you can go to my other Owned Pro guide. Right now, I'm gonna give you an overview of the updated Owned Pro free and premium version. So I'm gonna quickly go over this part here. You will see all the pre-installed scenes on the left, and then of course, a bunch of sources. They will all be unfolded and you can just delete what you don't need. So an example of this is here, webcam, and then webcam 2. You can delete one of them and then just keep the other one. You can delete stuff that you don't need. And something pretty important, you see the starting soon screen will have a countdown timer. Now, when we go back to the owned dashboard, you will see configure countdown on the left. And here you can choose the length of it. For example, 10 minutes, you click save changes. Now we go back to OBS and it will not change by default. You will need to hide the overlay and then show it again. And then it will reload and it will start counting again from the number you select on the website. Now I'm gonna go back to my overview and I'm gonna refresh the page, because you will see that right now we have an active overlay too. In the beginning we didn't have one, but we installed it in OBS. And you also see active alerts because we went to all alerts and then we chose one of them and we installed it. So we're gonna test it. On the right, you will see your event list. This is your recent events. This is just like in Streamlabs OBS. Right here, I'm recording with it, but you see mini feed, Jeff8615 is my latest follower. And as you see, Jeff is also right here. There's even a more recent one that isn't in Streamlabs OBS yet. Now you can replay an alert. So when we click on this and then we go back to OBS quickly, you will see that the alert is playing on top. So whatever alert you select here on the dashboard will be played in OBS as long as you've added the alert widget. Now, because we installed this complete pack, it is installed by default as you see owned alerts. But if you want to install it manually, you can click on the plus icon. And then we have a few owned tools here. We have owned alerts, which will show the alert that's installed on the website. We have owned chat. When we click on it and then click on OK, and then click on OK again, you will see your stream's chat here. So that's pretty neat. And there's another option when we click on the plus icon, it's owned labels. When you click on OK, you can choose latest follower, latest subscriber, and also countdown timer. So for example, latest follower, click on OK, and there we go. Here is our latest follower. If you double click it, then you will see that it adjusts to the size. So for example, if I make the height a bit less, for example, 30, you will see that it fits to the height. So the text will adjust to the maximum height. So if you take a height of, for example, 100, then you will need a lot of width to display the whole name. If the whole name doesn't fit the width, then it will start scrolling. If we make this bigger, for example, 1500, then you will see that it fits, so then it doesn't scroll. This is really handy. Okay, let's click on OK. I'm gonna delete this. I'm gonna delete the chat. So now you know, you can change your whole pack right here. Let's go back to the website. Let's go to configure alerts right now. So we selected our alerts theme, but we can also configure it. For example, when I click on follow, you will see that we have name between parentheses, just like with Streamlabs alerts. This will display the name of the person that's following. And then you can add whatever text you want after or in front of that. Now let's delete it first. And as you see, you can also click on test. Now when we click on it and we go back to OBS, you will see that the alert is being tested right now. So let's divide my screen into two parts. That will be much handier. You can do this yourself. That way you can change some things. For example, you delete everything except for the name. You click on test, you click on save changes on the bottom. And then when you click on test, you will see that the changes have been applied. Now, when we go to the donation alert, you will see that you have alert message, and this will be the message of the person donating. When we click on test, you will see that this is the message. Now, if you don't want to display the message of the donation on the alert, then you can just delete this, then you can save it, And then when we click on test, then it will just be the name of the person donating and then the amount. And the amount is because we have it right here. This is the name of the person donating. This is the amount. And then the other text, you can delete this. You can change this. You can do whatever you want with it. You can also click here to go to advanced settings. And then you can change the image. You can change the sound. These are settings that you'll recognize if you've ever used Streamlabs alerts. For example, the style here. So above the image is above the text, or the text on the image, or the text beneath the image. This is in case you want to use your own alerts, or you want to change some things of the alerts. You can customize everything right here when you click on this, and that way you can customize all your alerts. This is a chatbot that they are actively working on, and make sure you read this message because you have to give moderation rights to your bot, because otherwise it won't be able to moderate your chat. The name is owned, so you just do /mod owned. And that way you can give the chatbot all the rights that it needs. You can add commands right here, for example, for your socials, and then it returns your socials. You also have a moderation tab. Some other things they are still working on, for example, scan every message for toxicity. When you enable it, you will see that they say that it's currently in closed beta, so it's only available to their beta users. You can also add timers. An example of this is adding a promo message in your chat for your socials every 10 minutes or something like that. So it's say every 10 minutes, send, follow me on Instagram, blah, blah, blah. You click add timer, and then every 10 minutes, that message will get posted in chat. Again, don't forget to mod your own bot, because otherwise it won't be able to do that. Next, configure donations. You have a donation page, so owned.pro/thevideonerd. Let's go to that website. There you go. This is the donation page, the name, the amount, the currency, the message, and then people can tip you. But of course, right now it says that I don't have donations activated. Let's go back. You can add your PayPal email address right here, and then you will be able to activate your donation page. Next is configure countdown. We already went over this. A countdown timer will be included in the themes you install on OBS. Then here are a few other things of owned, for example, stream heroes. I'm not gonna go into this, but you can make cards of yourself, then viewers can earn energy by watching your stream. You can watch the trailer, it's here on top, and I will give you an explanation of what the stream heroes are. They also have owned music. This is copyright free music to play on your stream. More and more people are making copyright free playlists because streamers are looking for copyright free music, and owned is also working on that. You can listen to the music on Spotify, YouTube Music, Apple Music. They even have a live stream on Twitch that's constantly playing that music, so you can check that out. I'm gonna skip streamer shop for a minute, and then the last other thing is free panels. And this is a free template which you can download and then make your own panels in this style here, in these colors that you see on this image. You can make your own panels with this. And then the last thing is streamer shop. Now for this, you gotta know something else. Maybe you already know it, but owned has two websites, owned.tv and then owned pro, which is the thing we are talking about right now. Owned.tv is the website they started with, and it's a website with stream designs, with stream packages, and that was where you could buy complete stream packages. You buy one pack and then you keep it forever. Now on that website, they have a bunch of designs. And then owned pro, on the other hand, what we're talking about right now, is where you pay a monthly fee to be able to use all their designs that they have on owned.tv. So that's why they have so many designs on owned pro for the monthly fee. Now right here in the streamer shop, you can buy separate graphics which are from their other website. So when you subscribe to owned pro here, you get access to all their overlays and then all their alerts. But if you want to buy a separate thing, for example an offline banner, you can click on it, and then you will get brought to their other website where you can buy the banners separately. Now when you already have owned pro, you will not need to download, so the things that you can buy right here are the things that aren't included in the complete packages. Because when you subscribe to owned pro, as you see in OBS Studio, you get the complete stream overlay. But for example, the offline banner isn't included in this, because that's not for OBS Studio, that's for your Twitch profile. So then here you can buy separate offline banners. You can also buy sub emotes, sub badges, Twitch profile banners, and they also have an emote maker, a badge badge maker and then an avatar maker. You can check these out. For example, the emote maker allows you to customize your emote. You can choose hairstyles, stuff like that. So you can check this out if you want to buy any of these things. And then I think we went over everything that Owned Pro has. So I mainly made this video for the viewers of me who subscribe to Owned Pro and who want a complete overview of everything you can do with it. As I said during the video, if you're looking for a subscription-based graphic service, Owned Pro has a lot of designs. I mean, when we go to the overlays, this is a big page with a lot of designs, and they have 16 pages of this. So if that's what you're looking for, you're getting it with Owned Pro. If you want to learn anything else about streaming and you aren't subscribed yet, then please click on the subscribe button. And if you want an in-depth video on the complete setup of these packs in OBS Studio, where I go over every single source and show you how to set it up, you can go to that video or there, not sure, the video next to me, because there I went over the complete setup process of one of the overlays. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope that I will see you in one of my next videos. Have a nice day.